the keys there. I'm not a big football fan right from the get-go. We'll be clear on that one. Rooting for the Giants. I think they're going to win 30-17. I think that was my prediction from yesterday. 30, regardless, is my number, so I figured that's a lucky number. But it's exciting, you know, I think for this area. A lot of friends are big Giant fans, and so they're going to be watching this with a lot of interest. And we're going to do our own little party here after the game against Pittsburgh to watch it and enjoy it. And, there's big events in sports, and it's nice that the team of the area is involved in it.
Would you call yourself a Giants fan?
More than any other football team. But if the Jets would be there, I would root for the Jets too. Like, I'm not a diehard one way or the other. I think football, only in hockey, I don't root for the New York teams. That's it. The rest, I don't really care.
What do you think the temperature in the room is as far as rooting interest? Do you think it leans?
I think they're leaning more towards Giants, if you ask. But I'm not sure. I'm sure the Boston boys or, you know, anybody that's from that area, the New England area. But I would think New York is probably, you know, dominant in that effect.
30-17.
I think the Giants are going to win. I think that they've been playing really well. They had to scramble for their lives to get in the playoffs, and then they kind of carried that momentum in the first three games. And I think they're playing too well right now to get beat by New England.
Now, is the hometown thing, is that where you're going with the Giants, or?
Yeah, actually, I feel like I get myself in trouble if I don't say the Giants, so I kind of have to.
As a Vikings fan, is it hard to root for another NFC team? Does it not matter?
Really? I mean, they won 1, 2, 3 games this year, so it's not too hard.
You have a score in mind for Sunday?
I told Mark something the other day. I think I said like 30-24 or something. I can't remember. Something along those lines.
What are the plans for the team here? Who's watching the game where?
We got a Super Bowl party at Zuby's house. We're all going to go right after the Pittsburgh game and go watch.
And what do you think the sense is as far as how the room's split? Is it 50-50? Is it, I mean, you got a couple New England guys here, but.
Yeah, there are quite a few New England guys, but I don't know. I would say mostly it's going to be Giants. But there's a couple Jets guys in here, too, that probably don't want the Giants to win. So it's probably be split in half.
Who should the Jets fan be rooting for?
Yeah, but that's true. I don't even know who they should be rooting for, if they should be going for the. I don't know what would be worse, cheering for the Giants or the Patriots, but I think it's going to be probably half and half.
It's tough. Depends how long you've been a Jets fan, but I don't know. I'm going to wait till game time decision to decide this one, but I think being from New York and living here for a while, I've got to somehow cheer for the Giants. But it is a tough one to decide which team you want to win.
As a Jet fan, you're comfortable watching the Giants celebrate a second Super Bowl with Eli?
Yeah, it's tough. I think, you know, living in New York, I'm not like, I wasn't a huge football fan. I came in here, became a Jets fan because some things were given to me, and I just, you know, I just, everyone was a Giants fan. I was like, I'm cheer for the Jets. So it was one of those situations. But I don't know. I think living here for a while, you've got to cheer for the hometown team and hope they win.
So you're cheering for the hometown team. Who do you think is going to win?
Well, I'm saying that's who I should cheer for. I haven't decided yet. No, I'd like the Giants to win, yeah.
Who's going to win?
I think the Giants will win.
Okay. Keith, what are your keys to the game?
I don't know. If Cruz keeps running the ball like that, I think you're getting the ball in the middle, I think they'll be all right. And, you know, I think just showing in the playoffs and the end of the season how good they can play, so I think it'll be all right.
What do you think this does for Eli if he wins a second ring?
I think it's huge. I think it's another reason I got cheered for. I lived in this building last year, so I got to kind of root for them. But I think it's huge. I think when you have back-to-back, or not back-to-back, but you win a couple in the years that he has, it's confidence-wise, and he deserves it. He works hard. You saw him last game get hit hard a couple of times and gets up and keep playing. So I'm going to be quietly cheering for them.
I think whoever scores most is probably going to win. You know, I hope the Giants win. You know, being well, living this close to the city, you know, you become a Giants fan. I mean, everybody, you know, the friends that you meet that live around here are all Giants fans. They kind of got off the Jets bandwagon, so now everybody's rooting for the Giants. So I like to see this city go crazy. We've seen it before, and it was a pretty cool thing. So, but I honestly just want to see a good game one way or the other.
I think the Pats are going to pull it out. I think it's because, first of all, I think there's a lot of revenge factor going on. And I think also Brady played pretty bad last game. So I think he's going to be pretty psyched up for this. And, I mean, you can't count out Eli Manning and the Giants. But I think they're pretty comparable, but I think with the whole revenge factor and just, I think Belichick's going to pull something out.
Like I said, score more points. Defense is going to be an issue. And Giants' pass rush will be a big factor.
What about Gronk? Not 100%?
Yeah, exactly. I don't know, I think Gronk can pull it out. I think he's a big enough factor in the team that no matter, even if he's on the field, if he's not 100%, he's still got to watch him. He still can block. He's just a huge body to go up against that defensive line, so I think he'll be all right.
You know, going to Providence College, you kind of you watched the Patriots there for a while, so you know, I kind of became a fan that way. So I think I'd like to see him. You know, Brady went to Michigan, so he's been there before.
What about the fact that you play in this area?
Yeah, that's the only thing. That's the only downfall, but about rooting against the Giants. But they're both good teams. It's nice to see Giants come back from where they were towards the beginning and middle of the year. So I think now I'm leaning more towards the Pats, but it's going to be a tough game. So,
what's your sense of the rooting interest in the room? Is it lean one way or the other?
I think it's kind of both. I don't know about rooting interest. It's just kind of like who's going to take who. You know, a lot of guys are liking the Giants. A lot of guys are like, I think it's kind of mixed up right now. I think it's going to be Pats 24-20.
Half my friends in school were Giants fans and their half were Patriots fans for the most part, you know. A few Jets fans or whatever, what have you. But
nothing wrong with Jets fans.
Yeah. So my allegiance was kind of split. And the last time they played in the Super Bowl, I was kind of just like, I don't really care who wins. So I just hoping for an entertaining game, and it was really entertaining. So hoping for another entertaining game this time around. I'm sure they won't disappoint.
Seems like all the makings are there for another classic, maybe?
Yeah. I mean, there's no David Tyree to catch a ball against his helmet, but, you know. Brady and Belichick, can the Giants beat him twice in one season? We'll see. I mean, Giants D is playing unbelievable. So, and they took care of Rodgers' offense pretty effectively. So it'll be interesting to see. But I mean, if I had to wager money, if I was a betting man, you know, I might pick the Giants.